Okay, there's no diplomatic way to put it simply, so I'm just gonna say it like this. The top martial artist can only be a black person from a specific bloodline. I am the last, it ends with me. The top martial artist is the point of reference, okay, for what is morally superior, a truly superior choice. He defines the qualities of a man, and this has everything to do with martial arts principles. Determination, dedication, loyalty, right? Honesty, an honest conveyance, okay? Obviously, sabotage will start to confuse these things, but sparring clarified them in my time and will never be able to clarify it again because of the trajectory of technology. So number one, okay? The top martial artist should control society, should control all of humanity as the king of kings. It takes a great idiot to not understand why. It takes a complete fool to think that I'm talking about fighting and not sparring. Okay, sensibility, sensitivity, sensei, right? Sun C, sense A, or alpha, and so on and so forth. So the first point is straightforward. Think about it. Write it down. The top martial artist is the king of kings. If there's any spiritual matter, he should be the one who interprets it. Why would it be anyone else? What, technology, magic, inferior reason? They don't walk in the spirit of righteousness, morality, focused, intense, righteous indignation. They just don't. They're not sensitive enough to injustice to interpret things effectively. And we see that with the cowardice of the masses of the people these days, as I am the only one rising uncontrolled, insisting on the pure truth and focusing on the core truths. Number one, the top martial artist should be in charge. No attractive female has the right in truth, in morality, to reject him. Okay? Nor does anyone have the right in truth, in reality, to disobey him. Don't confuse that with this despicable, corrupt, government-based law of the masses. Number two, eugenics. Okay? This is a reproductive war. That's why it ends with me. And the attractive female is the most to blame. Now, a lot of you might say, well, why is that? Again, I tell you, write it down. The attractive female is the most to blame. So what angles bring us to this point? Let's first ask ourselves this. Okay, not only should it be apparent because of the influence they wield and who does what and why. Okay, if you're part of a social club, you see that there's a great emphasis on attaining the attractive woman, impressing her, and controlling culture so that people like you can have her. You're an idiot if you miss that the attractive woman is the tip of the arrow pointing down. Okay? Who, what, when, where, how, why. Number two, if you're concerned with money, and that's where your focus is, right? You're about your money, as they say. You see the importance of the female with marketing. Who buys what and why? It quite often, perhaps more often than not, has more to do with impressing an attractive female or being an attractive female trying to increase your power and in society, okay, than not. So, number three, if you're concerned with females, right, you think with your dick, you're a hopeless romantic, you're trying to get a date. If you think effectively, you will understand how much power the attractive female has versus the attractive male. And you will see that she's born with more power than the attractive man. She can marry a rich guy and divorce him and get his money. She can get men to do things they wouldn't otherwise do. People kill each other over women, and so on and so forth. Number three, religion. Okay, excuse me, number four. Angle that leads you here. Religion. If you're focused on religion, you should know without any doubt that the attractive female is key. How do you address the colonialist argument with Christianity, for example, in terms of the Pocahontas effect, if you will? Okay? The warrior chief cultures that existed before. If you're looking at this thing, and the sons of God saw the daughters of man, and the hijab that is worn by the Muslim woman, and so on and so forth. The traditionalism, who dates who and why? You're an idiot if you miss the significance of the attractive woman. Jezebel, the whore that rode the beast, the Virgin Mary depicted as attractive. How could you be a religious person, a Buddhist who doesn't believe in having sex, for example, and miss the significance and the influence? A monk, you know, a Catholic monk with a vow of celibacy. How could you miss how much influence the attractive woman has if you're truly focused on religion? How could you not see that this affects the future of your religion? And it affects how you can live your life and what laws exist and how hard it is on you. Certainly, if you're religious, you must see that the point, the tip of the arrow pointing down as humanity's direction is the attractive female, okay? The attractive women in society, the attractive females. Number five, if you are a man of morals and principles, a scientist perhaps, who's concerned with morality, how could you miss that the tip of the arrow pointing down is the attractive woman? You work the angles. What is right and what is wrong and why? You discuss with people. You give people advice. You mentor them. You counsel them. How could you miss it? 12% of gang-related homicides when I was younger, what I read, are related to romance. And I go as far as to say all gang-related homicides, if you think it through, are related to romance. Why do people steal? Why are people having a hard time surviving? Why is it wrong for a rich fogey to date an attractive, dumb, gold-digging slut? It all goes back to morals. Morals lead you to this. Is rape not part of a moral, your understanding of morality? How could you not see the influence? If you explore this idea and you focus on it, it leads you to this, the idea that the attractive woman is to blame. Okay? The people in charge, whoever they may be, would not have the influence over society they have if they didn't influence how women think. If women weren't hopelessly fixated on the things that they provide, the cultures that they have created, the money that they control. The next point, I think we're on number six now, the military. With all the rapes and war, how could you miss the importance of the attractive female? What are you fighting for? Some fucking barred wench, you know, who's retarded? You know, our culture. You know, what did Americans do when they got here? What did the colonists do? They started taking a bunch of Pocahontas-type chicks, okay? If you're in the military, chances are you're brain dead if you don't understand that the reason why the world is going to hell is the attractive female. Now, to overkill my point, I am going to put some pictures on the screen that prove my point, okay? So at the end of the day, who is the attractive female supposed to go to? She is supposed to go to the top martial artist and the martial art order, okay? If there's any left over after that, then it goes down to the craftsmen and all the bitches we see in society today in their various forms. There are no other martial artists in society today anywhere on the planet. They're not true martial artists. They're outside the true martial art order. They refuse to obey me. To marshal means to order, to arrange. If you refuse to take orders from the top martial artist, you are not a martial artist. Just like if you refuse to take orders from your general in the military and you go AWOL, you are not in the military, you went AWOL. It's very straightforward. Who could miss this? Who could not understand that I'm right when they hear it? Anyway. And how could you be the top martial artist if you don't emerge uncontrolled and insist on these truths? And then put out a sparring challenge that's open to everyone and doesn't favor the cheater. Anyway, so especially when we look at the trajectory of technology. So what we see here is that ultimately, spiritually, these are not polite suggestions. These are codes of conduct. These are rules handed down from God. Okay? And anyone who disobeys is not right with God, And they die a despicable death of not being right with God. Who would be proud of their child who dies without being right with God? How could you be proud of that child? That's a fucking pussy. Period. There have been fucking janitors, okay, that are scared of their own shadow that have died right with God. How the fuck could you respect a child like that? The child, that's one of the children of the devil. They never grew up to be a soldier of God. All right. So as we look at this thing, we see what is fair in this secular, profane world. You are robbing the wisest and the best out of something that's so important. The society is led straight to hell because of it. Certainly, no punishment for these harlots is too harsh.